Hi, my name is Laura Murphy, and welcome to my course, Contemporary Portraiture in Encaustic. So I have made my rabbit skin glue ahead of time. This can be used as a size on canvas or on panel. This is just plain rabbit skin glue. And what it is one part of rabbit skin glue crystals, which will keep forever. But once you add water to them, and once you make the glue, it'll only keep for about a week in the fridge. So this is one part of the glue crystals to 10 parts water. You soak it overnight, and then you heat it up the next day until all of the crystals are dissolved, and that's a glue.
So you heat it up and then
heat it up, yeah. You have to be very careful not to boil it. If you boil it, you'll totally lose the adhesion and your glue will be ruined. Just throw it out.
So it's 10 parts boiled. Water to 1 part rabbit skin glue,
yep.
Crystal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then you heat it up.
Heat it up.
You refrigerate it for...
Yeah, you can either use it right away or you can refrigerate it for up to a week. And it will keep. And then the whiting. So I'm going to mix one part whiting.
Whiting, what's that?
It's chalk.
Chalk.
Yeah, it's the chalk. And so I will put this through a sieve to make sure I have most of the big pieces out. And this can be used on canvas, it can be used on panel. If you're going to use it on canvas, don't use it too thickly, because while it does have some flexibility, it's not, if you use it too thick, it will crack. Okay, so that's that done. And then I'm just going to add one part of the glue. And you have to be careful with this. You're trying not to introduce too much air. So when you're mixing it, just kind of mix it lightly. If you find it's too thick, add a little more glue. Try not to have too much air in it. And that's basically it. So as soon as this is all absorbed, you have encaustic gesso. The panel is prepared by painting first in one direction with the gesso. You move slowly, make sure the gesso isn't too thick, and then when it's dry, turn the panel and paint in the opposite direction. You can then, if you want, paint again in the first direction. And then finish by smoothing with sandpaper.
So then just buying the...
Well, yeah. Okay, there's a couple of advantages as far as I'm concerned. There's no acrylic in it, so you don't have to worry about it flaking off. I actually like the process of making this. I love the technical aspects of all this sort of stuff, so I really enjoy it. It's also way cheaper. And I think I like to make panels. I like to kind of be invested in the whole process, you know, no matter where it starts. So, okay, so there we have gesso. It's just fun to try and see what happens. It may work perfectly for you, or it may not work at all. So we'll just see. That's kind of what it's for, is to, it's called a script writer, so it's kind of to, you know, to make writing, or to make circles, that kind of stuff. You can see, you know, all of the darker wax is coming out. You know, and if you need to move that around, just kind of move it with this, but just be careful, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And I'll be back to you in a couple of minutes.
Okay.
It might need to be a little hotter. Yeah, it needs to be a little hotter. Let's say, oops. Now you can scrape all of this off if you mm-hmm. want to. But just, you can see what it does. So you want to go ahead and, oops, and anything that goes on like that. And I think the way to do that would be to use just a little bit of, we could use a little bit of this. Actually, let's use a little bit of this color. So, do you want to take over now, Julia? Okay, and thanks to my wonderful students here at Gospenien and Aarhus. You guys did amazing work. As you can see, there's this incredible amount of work done in just 5 days. So thank you guys so much. It's been a real pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh.